Now see children, exercise, good morning to everyone. Now exercise 13.2, we are going to solve the fourth question. Okay, till third question we have done in the previous video, is it not? Now fourth question is, the diameter of a ruler is 84 cm and its length is 120 cm. It takes 500 complete revolutions to move once over to level a playground. Okay, to level a playground, the roller will roll 500 times. Okay, revolutions. Now, find the area of the playground in meter square. Means we have to find the first revolution, total surface area, and that is count surface area, because you know that roller, this is the roller shape, okay? So you know that roller means this side and this side, that means top and bottom side, okay, is not being rolled on the road, okay, or in the playground. So only this area, that means the curved surface area, is only being rolled, because here you know the device is attached like this to the roller machine, is it not? So only this part gets rolled on the road or on the playground. So this means what? This area means this to this, it is curved surface area. Curved surface area of the cylinder we have to find for one revolution. One revolution, curved area we have to find. Then how many revolutions will it take to complete the playground? That is 500. So one revolution, how much we are getting? Then 500 revolutions, how much? So that will be the area of the playground. So now see what is given. Given diameter of the roller is how much? 84 cm. Okay. So radius of the roller will be what? Diameter upon 2. Radius means you know diameter upon 2. So that is equal to 84 upon 2 centimeter, which is equal to, on dividing, we are getting 42 cm. Okay. Now height of the roller is also given. Given length of the roller is, that is height equals to how much? 120 cm. It is given in the question. Okay. Now therefore the curved surface area of the roller for one revolution. Okay. For one complete revolution, that is equals to 2 pi r h, because curved surface area formula is 2 pi r h of the cylinder. So that is 2 pi r h. Now put the value of 2 pi and r and h. Value of r and h you will put here. So that is 2 into 22 upon 7 into r is how much? 42, and then h is 120. So on multiplication and simplifying, what, how much you are getting? That is 31,680 cm². So this is the area of one revolution in the playground. So likewise, roller will take how many revolutions to complete the playground? That is 500. Total number of revolutions to level the ground is 500. So one revolution covers 31,680 cm² area. So 500 revolutions will cover how much? That is 500 into 31,680 cm². So that will, on multiplication, how much you will get? That is 158440. Okay. So this I can say that it is 1,58,40,000. 1,58,40,000 cm². This is in cm. So meters, generally land we are measuring in square meters. So I have to change this into meter. So you know that 1 meter equals to 100 centimeter. That means I have to divide with 100 into 100, because square is there. So I will divide with 10,000, because 100 into 100 gives what? 10,000. So whatever value is we got, on dividing with 10,000, we will get in meter square. So that is meter square. That gives what? All the zeros, four zeros, numerator and denominator gets cancelled. How much you will get? That is 1,584 m². Therefore, or thus, the area of the playground is how much? 1,584 m². Okay? Clear? fourth question is clear to everyone. Now see the fifth one. What is the fifth question says? Fifth question is a cylindrical pillar. Okay, pillar, all of you might have seen that electric poles and all. So likewise here a cylindrical pillar is 50 centimeter in diameter. Diameter is given as 50 centimeter and 3.5 meter in height. So you can see one measurement is given in cm, the other measurement is given in meter. So you have to change that cm into meter. Okay, so after that what is that in height? Find the cost of painting the curved surface of the pillar. Here already it is given that you have to find the curved surface of the pillar. Okay, where r is given, height is given, h is given. So formula of curved surface area, you know, 2πrh. Okay, so r and h value we will put there to get the curved surface area. After that what is given? At the rate of rupees 12.50, that means rupees 12.50 paise, rupees 12.50 paise per meter square, means 1 meter what is the charge of painting? 12 rupees 50 paise. How many meters curved area you will get? So that into rupees 12.50, okay, multiply, so you will get that many rupees to paint the cylindrical pillar. So now see the solution here. So the cylindrical pillar is likewise whose height is given as 3.5 meter and whose diameter is given as 50. So radius will be how much? Radius will be 25 cm. Now this cm, because the other measurement height is in meter and this is in cm, so when we convert this cm into meter, we will divide it with 100. So on dividing with 100 we will get 0.25 meter. Okay, so that is the radius. R is given, this one we got R. Height is given as 3.5 meter. Now given height of the cylindrical pillar H is 3.5 meter. Now the curved surface area of the cylindrical pillar equals to 2 pi R H. Now R value you put and H value you put. So on simplification how much you will be getting? That is 5.5 meter square. Okay. So this is the curved surface area of the cylinder which is to be painted. Okay, now what is the cost given? The given cost of painting the curved surface area of the pillar per meter square means 1 meter square, what is the cost? Rupees 12.50. okay, 50 paise. Now total cost of painting of the curved surface area will be this many square meters. Curved surface area is given, so rupees 12.50 into 5.5. okay, so on multiplication how much you will get? That is rupees 68.75. that means rupees 68.75 paise. so that is the cost of painting the cylindrical pillar. Okay, so this will be the answer. Now your sixth question and seventh question is your homework. It is as simple as like this. What is the question? You just see and I will explain you. Do it as homework. Sixth and seventh question is your homework. Homework, sixth and seventh question. Okay, solve as homework. Clear children? Now sixth question, see what is asked. Curved surface area of the right circular cylinder is 4.4 meter square. Means curved surface area value is given. Means 2 pi r h is equals to 4.4 meter square. If the radius of the base of the cylinder is 0.7 meter. Now, roughly I am saying, see 2 pi r h equals to 4.4 meter square. R is given. So now can you find h? 4.4 then into 7 upon 22 into 2, and then what is the value of R you see and put. Simply you will get, only you have to put the values of R, that's it, you will get the answer. Okay, so height can be found out. So do it as homework. Okay, very very easy one. And then the next question, seventh one. the inner diameter of the circular well. Well, all of you know. Okay, so in that you might have seen hollow part where the water is being stored. Okay, so there is a cement layer, you might have seen. The well is like this. Okay, likewise, and this is likewise. Clear? So now, this inner diameter means from here to here the diameter is how much? It is given, the inner diameter is 3.5 meter. Okay, and the depth of that well is how much? Height is given as depth of the well is 10 meter deep. Okay, depth h is given as 10. Find the inner curved surface. Very easy. R, your diameter is given, so you can find r. That is 3.5 upon 2. Okay, so you will get, because both the measurements are in meter, so no conversion, nothing, only diameter upon 2. That means 3.5 upon 2. And height h is given, r is given, h is given. Can you find the curved surface area? That is 2 pi r h. So find out that. Okay, that is the first one. Now second, the cost of plastering the curved surface at the rate of rupees 40 per meter square. Means the inner portion of the well, this inner portion, this is being plastered, not the outer one. So plastering of this means already we got the curved surface area. You got it using the formula. After that, 1 meter square cost rupees 40. It is given, what is given in the book? Yes, 1 meter square rupees 40. How much curved surface area you got after calculation? That many, that is equal to rupees 40 into how much you got here that you put there, curved surface area. Okay, you will get the answer. Clear? So do that as a homework. Now the next question, that is 8th question. 8th question is, in a hot water heating system, okay, there is a cylindrical pipe. You might have seen geyser and all. Okay, geyser, all of you might have seen, in that pipe is there for water supply. Okay, so that is a cylindrical pipe of length 25 meter. What is the length of the pipe? 28 meter. And diameter is 5 centimeter. Diameter is 5. So radius will be how much? 5 upon 2. Okay, find the total radiating surface in the system. Total radiating means what? Total curved surface we will take. What is the formula of it? That is 2 pi r into r plus h. Okay, here r is given to us, h is given to us. So can we find that? Now see that. Now given, length of the cylindrical pipe h is how much? 28 meter. Like this, the cylindrical pipe is, whose length is 28 meters, and diameter is given as 5. So radius will be how much? 5 upon 2. Okay, so now height is 28 and diameter of the cylindrical pipe, that is diameter, equals to 5 cm. That implies what? Radius. Radius of the cylindrical pipe r equals to 5 upon 2 cm. Now it is in cm, but the other measurement height, you can see it is in meter. So both the units are not same. One is in meter, the other one is in centimeter. So that centimeter one, we will change it into meter. So 5 upon 2 cm, if I am going to change this into meter, I will have to divide with 100. Okay, so that is 5 upon 200 meter. Clear? Conversion we all know. So this will be the radius of this cylindrical pipe. Now, the total radiating surface of the system, total radiating surface of the cylinder will be how much? That is total surface area of the pipe. So total surface area, it is a cylindrical pipe. So we know that total surface area of the cylinder is what? 2 pi r into r plus h, formula we know. Now here we will put the value of r and h, that is equals to 2 into 22 upon 7 pi value into r is how much? 5 upon 200 into within bracket r is how much? 5 upon 200 plus h is 28. So now here unit will be meter square, because every both the measurements are in both the height and radius is in meter only. So that is why here it will be meter square. Now implies 2 into 22 upon 7 into 5 upon 200 into, now LCM, taking LCM of this one as 200, and on simplification how much we are getting, that is 5605 upon 200 meter square. So now on simplification of this, how much we are getting, that is equals to 4.403 meter square. Now when we go for round off means approx value, how much you will get, that is 4.4 meter square. Okay, so now this is the total radiating surface. So thus the total radiating surface of the system equals to 4.4 meter square. Okay. See children, the next question we'll take, that is the ninth question. Ninth question, what is asked? First one, find first the lateral or curved surface area of a closed cylindrical petrol tank, storage tank, that is 4.2 meter in diameter and 4.5 meter in height. One is in meter, both are in meters, and one is the diameter, that is 4.2, and the height is 4.5. Now see, and the second part is what? Second part is how much steel was actually used? If 1/12 of the steel actually used was wasted in making the tank. Okay, so waste is in making the tank means that waste part we have to eliminate from the whole steel. Okay, that we will see in the later part. First we will see the calculation part of curved surface area, the first part of it. That is, given diameter of the closed cylindrical petrol storage tank is how much? 4.2. Okay, meter is given. So radius will be how much? Half of it. So radius equals to 4.2 upon 2, that is equals to 2.1 meter. Okay, half of the diameter is the radius. Now given height of the closed cylindrical tank is how much? That is h, this is h, is it not? Height of the closed cylindrical tank is h equals to 4.5 meter. Okay, now therefore curved or lateral surface area, first questions what is to be find, that is the curved or lateral surface area of the tank equals to 2 pi rh. We know the formula of curved surface area of a cylinder, that is 2 pi rh. Now here we know the value of r and we know the value of h. When we put here in the formula, we will get the value of curved surface area, that is here 2 into pi value is 22 upon 7 into r is how much? 2.1, and into h is how much? 4.5 meter square is the unit. Now on simplification of this, we will be getting 59.4 meter square. Okay, now come to the second part. First part is done. Now second part, what is given? That is total surface area of the tank, because steel metal is used in the top, bottom as well as the curved surface area. Everywhere it is used. It is a closed cylindrical storage petrol tank. Okay, closed means it will be total surface area of the cylinder. We will use that formula. So total surface area of the tank is 2 pi r into r plus h. You know the formula. Now here r value is known to us, h value is known to us. So we'll put here to get the answer. That is 2 into pi value is 22 upon 7 into r is 2.1 into, here within bracket we'll put the value of r, that is 2.1, plus h value is 4.5. Outside the bracket we will have meter square as the unit. Now that is equals to 2 into 22 upon 7 into 2.1 into, on addition of these two, we will get 6.6 meter square. Now on simplification of this, we will get 87.12 meter square. Okay, so that is the total surface area of the closed cylindrical petrol tank. Now What is given? Like total area of the steel used in making tent. Because how much steel is used, we do not know. So let us assume that the total area of the steel used in making the tent, that is x meter square. Okay, because area is given means meter square will come. So that is equals to x meter square. Now what is given in the question? That steel wanted in making that, therefore steel wanted, this will be wasted. This is wasted. The steel wasted in making tent is 1/12 of the actual steel. That is the steel used for making the tent. What is the steel used for making the tent is x. So 1/12 of it is wasted. So 1/12 means 1/12 of x means 1/12 into x. Okay, of means multiplication, we know that. So 1/12 of x. So now actually how much it is used? This is the total steel, x meter square, and this is wasted. So how much it will be? So that will be steel actually used in making tent equals to x, that is the steel for steel used for making tent minus the steel wasted one. Okay, so that is 1/12 of x. That is equals to x is common in both the cases, so we'll take as common. Now 1 minus 1/12 into x. So now on simplification, taking LCM, we will get 12, and then 12 minus 1 will be 11. So 11/12 x. So this much steel is used. But according to the solution here, how much steel is used? Because total surface area. So total surface area means whole area is covered, whole tank is covered with steel. Okay. So total surface area of the tank we got as 87.12 meter square. And here how much steel is used, that also we got, that is 11/12 x. So that is why now 11/12 x equals to 87.12 meter square. Understood why? Because this much actual steel is used for making the tank, and total area of the tank we got, how much it is? This much, 87.12 meter square. So this will be equals to this, because this much steel is used and this much total area is there of the tank. Okay, so 11/12 x equals to 87.12 meter square. So now on simplification of this, x will be equals to cross multiply. What you will get? 87.12 into 12/11 meter square. That is equals to, on simplification we are getting 95.04 meter square. Thus total steel area of steel used in making the tank is how much? 95.04 meter square. Because that we have taken as x. Total steel used is x. So value of x we got as what? 95.04 meter square. Therefore, the actual, that means the steel used, the area of the steel used in making the tent is 95.04 meter square. So that is the answer for this question. Now the next question, that is the 10th question, we'll see now in figure. In the book, figure is given. You see the frame of a lamp shade. You might have seen bed lamps we are using. In that, many decorative pieces are made out of it. That is the lamp shade we used to say. Okay, so designer one. So likewise, one of the lamp shade is given in the figure. Okay, it is to be covered with a decorative cloth. That lamp shade is used or covered with a cloth which is decorative one, or decorative cloth. The frame has a base diameter of 20 centimeter. That means this is the figure given. So base diameter is how much it is given? That is 20 cm. Okay, the base diameter. A margin okay, so base diameter is given as 20 cm and height of 30 cm. So this height is of 30 cm. Okay, Now after that, what is given? A margin of 2.5 centimeter is to be given for folding it over the top and the bottom of the frame. Now, how much cloth is required for covering the lampshade? Now see, this cloth is covered from here top 2.5 centimeter and down also it is covered with 2.5. So total height of this cloth, the length of the cloth will be how much? 30, the height of the lampshade, plus 2.5 plus 2.5, that is also the cloth we need to fold inside and inside from the top and the bottom. Clear, understood? So the total length of the cloth will be how much? 30 plus 2.5 plus 2.5. Clear, understood? Because when we are making a frame, frame height is given as 30 centimeter. Okay, when we are using the cloth, we know that with the fabricor or something, we are folding the cloth on the top and the bottom. Okay, so bottom, top 2.5 centimeter cloth is folded, down also 2.5 cloth is folded inside. Okay, so total length of the cloth will be how much? 30, the height of the lampshade, plus 25 which is folded, down 2.5 which is folded. Clear? So the height of the cloth will be 30 plus 2.5 plus 2.5, that is equals to 35 cm. Okay, so height of this particular lampshade will be, of the cloth is 35 cm, and base diameter is given as what? 20 cm. So radius will be how much? Half of it. So base radius r equals to 20 upon 2, so that is equals to 10 cm. Okay, now radius we got, height we got. You know that it is a curved cylinder. Okay, because top is open, lampshade you all might have seen, top is open, bottom is also open, in between only bulb is fit, right? So this is your curved surface area we will take. So now the total cloth required for covering the lampshade equals to curved surface area of the cylinder or the lampshade. This lampshade is in the form of a cylinder, so it is curved surface area of the lampshade or the cylinder. So area, the curved surface area of the cylinder, we know formula, that is 2 pi rh. R value we know, h value we know. So can we find after calculation? Do it. That is 2 into 22 upon 7 into 10 into 35, then cm square. So on calculation of this, we will get, you all have to calculate this, and that is equals to 2200 cm square. Thus the cloth required for covering the lampshade equals to 2200 cm square. Clear, understood? So that is the answer for that. And the last question C of that 11th question is, the student of Vidyalaya were asked to participate in a competition for making and decorating pen holders. You all might have seen pen holder, base is closed but the top is open because we are keeping the pen likewise. So that means base is closed, otherwise pen will drop, is it not? So it should be covered. So total surface area minus the top one open, so that is a circle. So minus circle area. Clear? Or you can do curved surface area of the cylinder plus area of the circle, because down portion is also a circle of the pen holder. Either way, either the curved surface area plus the area of the circle, or total surface area minus the area of the circle, because the top is open, only the top is open in the pen holder, bottom is covered. Clear? So now what is given? So the cylinder with a base using cardboard, each pen holder was to be of the radius 3 cm. So radius of this pen holder will be how much? 3 cm. And height of this pen holder will be 10.5 cm. Okay, the Vidyalaya was to supply the competitors with cardboard. Okay, that means Vidyalaya is responsible for giving all the competitors the cardboard to prepare the pen holder. So how much cardboard will be required by the school or the Vidyalaya? Clear? That we have to find. Okay, how much So there are how many competitors? If there were 35 competitors, how much cardboard was required to buy for the competition? That means total 35. We will find the area of the one pen holder. So how many competitors are there? Then that many pen holders will be made. So 35 pen holders, what will be the area? We will see. Now see, given radius of the pen holder is how much? 3 cm. Seeing the figure also, we can understand the radius is 3 cm. And the height of the pen holder is how much? 10.5 cm. Now, therefore, area of cardboard used in making pen holder will be curved area, that is curved surface area of pen holder plus area of the base of pen holder. As I said, either you take curved surface area plus area of the base pen holder, or you can take total surface area of the pen holder minus the area of the top pen holder. Clear? Understood? So here curved area of the cylinder, we know curved surface area of the cylinder, that is 2 pi rh plus, this is 2 pi rh plus area of the base pen holder will be how much? Area of the circle, because base is a circular one, cylinder's base is circular. So area of a circle is how much? Pi r square. So in these two, what is common? That is pi and r. So take pi and r as common. Then what is left out from here? Pi and r gone means 2h. So 2h plus r. Now put the values. That is 22 upon 7, because pi value is what? 22 upon 7 into r is 3, within bracket 2 into h value is 10.5 plus 3 cm square, which is equals to 22 upon 7 into 3. On simplification of this, we will get 21 plus 3 cm square. That is equals to 22 upon 7 into 3 into the addition of these two, we will get 24 cm square. So this one do not divide now, because you can see that this is not divisible. So you will get in fraction or in decimal. So let it be like that, because you need to find for 35 pen holders. So 35 is divisible by 7. So that way you can go for it. So leave the fraction likewise only. Okay. Now, total number of competitors are how many are there? 35. So this is required for one. This is required for one pen holder for one competitor. Right? This is the area of one pen holder for one competitor. How many competitors are there? 35. So total cardboard required will be how much? That is 35 into 22 upon 7 into 3 into 24 cm square. Now you know that 35 is divisible by 7. Now cancel it off, 5. So it will be 5 into 22 into 3 into 24 cm square. Now on multiplication of this all number, we will get how much? 7920 cm square. So this much area of cardboard is required for the competition. So that's why, thus total cardboard required equals to 7920 cm square. So this comes to an end of your 13.2 exercise. Next topic we will see, that is the cone, in the next video.